Now we are going to see the last example of electrolysis. Let us connect the electrical generator or electric tension to two graphite rods that are dipped, that are immersed into a solution, into an aqueous solution of sodium sulfate. Let's see what is going on in this system. We have that at the graphite rod that is connected to the negative pole of the electric tension generator, we have the two possible reduction reaction may occur. One is the reduction of the sodium ion, Na plus plus one electron that gives metallic sodium, and the second is the reduction of the hydrogen or water, namely two water molecules, two H2O, which reacts with two electrons, thus giving rise to the evolution of gaseous hydrogen plus two hydroxyl ion. We see that the potential that these two reactions are said to occur, we can find this value on the electrochemical series, and we see that the potential to which this reaction occurs is -2.711 volts, and as far as the reduction of hydrogen or water, the potential at this reduction of reaction occurs is found to be on the electrochemical series to be equal to -0.826. In the previous example, in which we saw the electrolysis of the sodium chloride solution, we saw that when the difference of potential is such large as in this case, we have that always the reaction which exhibit the more positive, namely the less negative potential, occurs. So the difference between -0.8 and -2.7 is about 1.9 volt. It means that surely, definitely, the reaction of reduction of hydrogen or water will occur. So this is the cathodic reaction. So at the cathode we will have the evolution of hydrogen. Let's see what occurs at the positive pole, at the graphite rods that is connected to the positive pole of the tension of the generator or electrical tension. We have that one reaction that can occur is the oxidation of oxygen or water, and in this reaction that two molecules of water transforms into one molecule of gaseous oxygen, four electrons, and four hydroxonium ion. And this reaction occurs at a potential of -1.229. Then we see that no other oxidation reaction may occur in the system because sulfate ion may not undergo any oxidation reaction. Why? Because sulfur in sulfate ion already exhibits its highest oxidation number, which is +6. This is the reason why sulfate ion may not undergo any oxidation reaction more. So, at the cathode, we have the reduction of the hydrogen or water, which gives rise to the evolution of gaseous hydrogen at the cathode. At the anode, we have that the oxidation of oxygen or water, which gives rise to the evolution of gaseous oxygen at the anode. The result of this electrolysis of this aqueous solution of sodium sulfate is the electrolysis of water. Namely, we have that to form water, oxygen and hydrogen are bond together by covalent bond. By performing an electrolysis of a gas of an aqueous solution of sodium sulfate, we have that the result of this electrochemical operation is the separation of the oxygen and the hydrogen that form water, with the evolution of gaseous hydrogen to the cathode and gaseous oxygen to the anode. Okay. One could wonder, but if sodium does not take any part in this reaction, and also this sulfate ion does not have any part in this chemical reaction, why it is necessary that sodium sulfate is present in this solution? Well, if we perform the electrolysis of distilled water, namely distilled water meaning that here there are only molecules of water and there are not ions such as sodium and sulfate, we have that the electrical conductivity of distilled water is very low. So the electrolysis cannot occur because distilled water has a too low electrical conductivity. So the presence of sodium sulfate is absolutely necessary to make conductive, to allow electrical current to pass through the solution. Okay, it must be said that all these operations that we performed in pile and that we performed in electrolysis are performed in direct current, not in alternate current. Namely, the phase of the current is always the same. Okay, so we are talking always of direct current. Well, it must be also said that it's not absolutely necessary that in this solution in which we perform the electrolysis of water is present sodium sulfate. There must be some electrolyte which make the solution conductive, which increases the electrical conductivity of the electrolyte solution. The problem is that a proper electrolyte must be chosen, in the sense that when the electrolyte dissolves into the solution, the ion arising from the dissolution of the electrolyte must not interfere with the reaction that occurs at the electrode of the electrolysis. As an example, we have that sodium nitrate is a proper electrolyte. Sulfuric acid is also a proper electrolyte. Potassium sulfate is a proper electrolyte. Sodium hydroxide is also a proper electrolyte. And why they are considered proper electrolyte? If we dissolve sodium nitrate instead of sodium sulfate, we have that at cathode is the same this case. If the reaction of reduction of sodium ion and reaction of reduction of hydrogen of water may occur, we know that given the large difference of electrical potential at which these two reactions occur, being very large this difference, the reaction occurring at the highest, namely at the less negative potential, will occur. And in this case, will always be the reaction of reduction of hydrogen or water. Then, as far as nitrate ion is concerned, we have that in nitrate ion, nitrogen exhibits its highest oxidation number, namely plus 5. So a nitrate ion act in the same way, behave in the same ways as sulfate ion. So it may not undergo any oxidation reaction. This is the reason why, also if we dissolve sodium nitrate in water, the electrolysis of water will occur. Because at the cathode, the reduction of hydrogen water will occur because it occurs at a higher potential, namely at a less negative potential. And at the anode, only the reaction of oxidation of water will be able to occur. As far as sulfuric acid is concerned, we have that. If we dissolve sulfuric acid will dissolve into solution, thus giving rise hydroxonium ion, hydrogen sulfate ion, and sulfate ion. Well, the hydroxonium ion will react at the cathode, thus giving rise to the reaction H plus plus one electron, which gives rise to 1/2 molecule hydrogen H2. And this reaction will occur. And at the cathode, we will have that the sulfate ion or the hydrogen sulfate ion will not give rise to any oxidation reaction, as sulfur exhibit its highest oxidation number in sodium, in hydrogen sulfate ion and in sulfate ion. The same things occurs if we choose as electrolyte potassium sulfate. Potassium, now at this moment I cannot remember exactly its potential of reduction, but will be something like this. I can't remember if a little bit higher or if a little bit lower, but the difference of potential at which the reduction of potassium ion undergoes, it will be very large, and the reduction of hydrogen or water will occur at a far lower potential than the reduction of the potassium ion. So if potassium ion and hydrogen or water may reduce, always the reduction of the hydrogen or water will occur, because it will occur at a less negative potential. As far as sulfate ion may not undergo any oxidation reaction because of the same reason that we've been saying before. As far as sodium hydroxide is concerned, we have that the two possible cathodic reduction reaction will always be the reduction of sodium ion and the reduction of water. And we have been saying many times that when these two reactions are possible, always the reaction of reduction of hydrogen or water will occur, because it occurs at a less negative potential. Then at the anode, the reduction of the oxygen of hydroxonium ion will occur, and it will give rise to the production of gaseous oxygen. As an example of electrolyte that are not proper to attain the goal of electrolysis of water, there are copper nitrate and sodium chloride. As far as copper nitrate is concerned, we have that if we dissolve copper nitrate in water, we will have that as cathodic reaction, we will have the reduction of copper ion, Cu plus two electron, which gives rise to metallic copper, and the reduction of hydrogen and water, namely this reaction. This reaction occurs at a potential which is -0.826. Whereas the potential at which the reduction of copper ion occurs is +0.34. So there is a large difference of potential, but in this case, the more positive potential is the potential of reduction of the copper ion. So when there are copper ions in solution, we will always say the reduction of copper ion and never the reaction of hydrogen or water. So at the cathode, we will not have the evolution of hydrogen, but we will have that the road of graphite that is dipped into the solution, we will be covered by a thin layer of copper that will be deposited by the electrolysis operation. If we choose, if we select sodium chloride as electrolyte, also sodium chloride is not proper to attain the goal of water electrolysis, because in the previous example we have been studying the electrolysis of a sodium chloride solution, and we saw that at the anode, chloride ion is oxidized to chlorine gas, and is not oxidized the oxygen or water. The reason we have been already seeing, and we saw that, you know, although the potential at which the oxidation of chlorine is more negative, -1.355, is more negative than -1.229, that is potential at which the reduction of hydrogen or water occur, we see that to this term, another term Y for the reduction of chlorine and X for the reduction of oxygen or water must be summed. That must win the inner resistance of the electrical circuits. And this amount Y is smaller than this amount X. So if we sum these two amounts, -1.355 plus minus Y, this sum will be less negative than -1.229 plus minus X. So this is the reason why. Although -1.365 is a lower value than -1.229, this sum is less negative than this sum. And this is the reason why the oxidation of chlorine will occur instead of the oxidation of the oxygen on water. So this is the reason why in water electrolysis we will have that sodium chloride is a not proper electrolyte to attain the goal of a water electrolysis. Well, now this course of lesson is over. I would like only to wish to you to study very well and to pass the exam in the shortest time is possible and with the highest satisfaction by yourselves. Goodbye.